This hour brought to you by GCNLife.com. Live younger, look younger, feel younger at GCNLife.com.
Perpetually standing in the breach and always ready to stay in the fight. Coming to you from an undisclosed broadcast location. Presented by AR-500 Armor. The Armored Republic cometh. This is Lock and Load with Bill Frady.
Hour number two, coming to you live from the AR-500 Armor Radio Studio. This is Lock and Load. This portion of the show is brought to you by Boyd's Gun Stocks.
Who needs a Boyd's hardwood gun stock? Everyone. Crack stock, back in action. Not the best fit? Now it's made for you. Tired look? Now the coolest gun in camp. Want tighter groups? Now you're more accurate than ever. A new Boyd's hardwood gun stock will make your firearm fit, function, and look better than ever. Boyd's. Rock your stock. Rock your gun.
Check them out at boydsgunstocks.com. Well, today is Thursday, middle hour. That means it is time for Planet Rick. Starring Rick Ector, urban self-defense instructor out of Detroit. Good evening, sir.
Hey, man, good morning. Good morning. Good evening to you. How are you doing today?
I'm doing okay. I actually had my other mixer wired in here, and it had, like, reverb and all kinds of special effects mixed into it. So when I did Planet Rick, it was going to sound epic. And, right. Of course, it started making other noises it's not supposed to make, which is why
practice is always necessary, which is going to be a theme for us today. But, yeah, man. Hey, look, it's okay. This thing is still new. We're talking about Planet Rick, and I'm expecting it to be galactic, pun intended.
The galactic Planet Rick. Planet Rick is galactic. Hey, I like it. So what are we talking about today, Swami? What are we doing?
Well, today, you know, just following the evolution of the things that we've talked about thus far, man, I thought it'd be very important if we started to put our big toe in the whole subject of practice. Practice makes perfect. Practice, practice, practice. I want to sound like Allen Iverson during that one interview he did after missing practice one day. And the media really took him to task for being, you know, this big star, prima donna, who didn't feel like he had to come to practice. And if you ever get a chance, I tell you and your listeners to Google Allen Iverson rant on practice. It is the most funniest thing in the world. But practice, practice, practice is very important when we're talking about personal protection.
So how often do you recommend somebody shoot per month, per week? What's the regularity? What should be the regularity?
Well, I mean, once a person achieves a certain level of proficiency where, you know, where they're definitely safe with a gun, you know, I would say you need at a bare minimum, you know, and this is like extreme minimum, at least 50 rounds a month. Now, for a lot of your listeners who are some really hardcore gun people, that seems a little light. But you know what? As a trainer, and I talk with people all the time, whether it's training events I do for the community or whether it's people who are renewing their CPLs after, you know, the statutory renewal period, 4 or 5 years, or people I just come across, practice is not on most people's minds, man. It just doesn't seem to be the thing that they're really making time for, and it needs to be taken more seriously. You need to go at a bare, ultra minimum, once a month, 50 rounds. Bare minimum. I recommend higher, but you know what? I'm talking bare minimum.
Right. 50 rounds, though, I mean, that's more than one magazine. That's a pretty good warm-up, right? And, I mean, you know, if you're taking your time and everything, that's going to help you develop those good habits.
Well, yeah. I mean, you know, shooting is, I tell people all the time, I compare it to riding a bicycle. I mean, pretty much everyone who listens to your show has probably rode or ridden a bicycle at some point in time in their life, you know. And once you get over that ability to balance and to ride your bike, it's one of those things that you can do. It lasts for a lifetime, right? Like, take you. When was the last time you rode a bicycle?
Actually, you know, I ride a bicycle for a form of exercise, so I haven't ridden one this week.
Yeah. Okay, well, let's just pretend, you know, we're role-playing, right? Haven't ridden a bicycle.
I haven't ridden since I was 12.
Right, and we're not even going to say how many decades that actually is. But let's just say you're of sufficient age where people, when they see you, you know, they say, sir, you know, that you're that old, right? So if you were to go get on a bicycle, and I'm assuming no training wheels, you could get on it and maybe be a little wobbly just to start out. But once you got your bearings together, you could ride it up and down the street with no problem. Well, see, shooting a gun is different. It's what we call a depreciable skill. You can't just pick up a gun after, you know, 30 years and all of a sudden your accuracy that you're going to need, presumably, if you need it to defend yourself, protect your family, you're going to be really accurate, you know. So you need to have some maintenance. You need to practice on a regular, ongoing basis, man, at least bare minimum, 50 rounds a month, and that's really on the light end. But, you know, when you're talking about practicing and this whole gun thing, there's costs associated with practice, you can imagine, right?
Well, I mean, just ammunition, if you have to be a member of a club or go to a range or something like that, there's going to be cost.
There are costs associated with it, and you know what? When you give out, you know, advice to a broad audience, you know, just say a typical class, man. You're going to have such diversity in the classroom with regards to their backgrounds, their income, their living arrangements, et cetera. You know, there's going to be some variance there. So 50 rounds bare minimum once a month is an absolute must just to maintain your ability and to keep yourself from missing.
This brings to mind, you know, a lot of these things that these people do, the anti-gunners, they want to limit how many rounds you can keep. And for like somebody taking a class, somebody going to a class and training, like going for a weekend of training, that can be 1,000 rounds real easy.
You know, 1,000 rounds isn't a lot of rounds of ammunition. And to the uninitiated, to someone who's not, you know, really familiar with guns, right, you could say, hey, yeah, I got a case of 1,000 rounds of ammunition at the house, and someone's eyes might glaze over and their mouth might drop to the floor. And they're like, wow, that's an awful lot of ammunition. And then you'll see those anti-gunners on the TV talk shows. No one needs 1,000 rounds of ammunition. Well, let me tell you, if you're a person who takes your training seriously, especially for personal protection and self-defense, and you go to maintain your ability to shoot accurately and safely, 1,000 rounds is nothing.
It's just the beginning. I mean, I think right now in the house I've got about 2,000 rounds of 9mm.
Now, see,
You're saying?
No, like to some people who are just getting into this whole personal protection, self-defense thing, they'll hear you say 2,000 rounds, and they're like, my God, that's an awful lot of ammo.
Is he going to war? Really? Why does he need that much? When I film guns, right? I've got this Sunday, I will probably film at least one gun, maybe two. And when I go and film guns, that's going to be a minimum of 400 rounds right there just to film them. That's right. Not even training. That's just me, you know, standing there pulling the trigger in front of a camera. And I'm trying to hit what I'm aiming at. That's where I get a lot of my practice.
You know, it's very embarrassing to be a media producer, right? And you're producing an instructional film and you miss your target. Man, I'll tell you real quick. I was doing a.
I'll tell you what. Hold it because we're about to come to break and I want to hear this. Although I will tell you that I always have a guy in the background with a gong and a hammer. So it always looks like I'm shooting at steel. So I never miss. Rick Ector is the head of Legally Armed in Detroit. He is the head of Rick's Firearms Academy, and he is the star of Project Rick right here on Lock and Load. We'll be right back. This is Lock and Load.
have the Knights of the Round Table. They understood body armor has long been a necessary tool. Today, AR-500 armor sets the standard for steel core body armor. Reimagining ballistic steel, AR-500 armor employs a fragmentation and spalling coating to mitigate damage, giving you that second chance to stay in the fight. AR-500 armor is the leading high-value solution for body armor. AR500armor.com. Join the Armored Republic and stay in the fight.
Today, weapons and optics are built tough, but they have to remain dialed in. Enter Air Armor Tech. Created to protect the $500,000 helmet of the F-35 Lightning II aircraft, Air Armor Tech can likewise protect your weapons during transport. Under pressure, air is uncompromising, rigid or collapsible using the power of inflation or deflation, high-tech and elemental. To learn more, go to airarmortech.com. Air Armor Tech. Protective. Lightweight. These are military-grade inflatable cases.
When you have a pain in the neck, a real pain in the neck, back, shoulder, or legs, you now have two convenient choices to get fast relief without taking another pill. Because now, Sunny Bay heating wraps and pillows are available at both Amazon and Walmart. Yes, see Sunny Bay's 4.5 to 5-star customer reviews on Amazon.com or Walmart.com. Our microwavable heat wraps, heatable neck pillows, and extra large body wraps are designed better for perfect support where and when you need it. Even while driving, Sunny Bay wraps will not burn and stay balanced to provide soothing hot or cold therapy to help treat temporary or chronic pain. And the best part, Sunny Bay quality products start at under $20. Join thousands of happy customers and see why Sunny Bay products have a lifetime 100% positive rating on both Amazon and Etsy. It's easy. Click Amazon or Walmart and search today for Sunny Bay.
Do you feel like many of us?
All the distractions in the world taking our minds and focus off what really needs to get done day to day?
Well, Jeunesse has a dietary supplement called Mind to help with mental distraction, and it supports memory function. Go to GCNLife.com now to check it out. You're only at your best when your mind is at its best. Go to GCNLife.com or call toll free 844-443-6637. That's GCNLife.com or 844-443-6637.
What would your life be like if you woke up each morning with new vitality, feeling better than you have in years, and you noticed a difference in your sleeping patterns, blood sugar levels, and had a sense of well-being overall? There's something that is changing thousands of people's lives, and you could be one of them. It's called Heart and Body Extract. Sharon Harris, co-creator of Heart and Body Extract, talks about the positive effects of Heart and Body Extract.
What happens with the formula Heart and Body Extract is it's giving the body the necessary vitamins, minerals, amino acids, enzymes, and phytonutrients so the body will heal itself. And yes, the body does have the ability to balance blood pressure, balance cholesterol, clean and unclog the arteries. It can also work on balancing the circulation for diabetics. So the body is an amazing thing. It simply needs some help so it has the tools to heal itself.
Heart and Body Extract gets results. To order your 2-month supply, call now, toll free at 866-295-5305. Order online at hbextract.com.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists, get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and sling bows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
Coming to you live from the AR-500 Armor Radio Studio. This is Lock and Load. This portion of the show is brought to you by Boyd's Gun Stocks.
Who needs a Boyd's hardwood gun stock? Everyone. Cracked stock? Back in action. Not the best fit? Now it's made for you. Tired look? Now the coolest gun in camp. Want tighter groups? Now you're more accurate than ever. A new Boyd's hardwood gun stock will make your firearm fit, function, and look better than ever. Boyd's, rock your stock, rock your gun.
In indeed. Check them out at boydsgunstocks.com. I am talking to Rick Ector. He is the star of Planet Rick. We were talking about practicing just now. I guess it becomes now, for people that live in a city where they're actually allowed to carry guns, like Detroit, it's not so easy a thing for them to go practice, is it?
You know, you have a national audience. So, yeah, there are some people who do not live in the big urban, you know, cities, you know. And I'm not going to pretend like Detroit is this big, major urban metropolis. We're probably dropped down to like maybe eighth on the population, you know, list in the country in terms of largest cities, man. But if you live in a relatively large city, and I'm guessing we're somewhere around 600,000, 500,000, somewhere around there, depending on who you listen to, man, you probably... You know, if you're in the city, there are probably aren't many venues that you can go to in general where you can go shoot. And then there's a lot of places nationally where even though you have a lot of people there, like Chicago, you know, or Detroit, you don't have a gun range actually within the geographical borders of the city. So those create their own challenges, and then you have to go venture out, you know, into the suburbs, and that might be some distance to you to actually get there. And then, you know, depending on how many ranges there are there, you know, it might be some weight involved. So, yeah, we could do a lot better, and I don't want to really delve into the whole how come Chicago has to sue the government to, you know, get gun ranges. Well, I think we probably need to do something like that here because we don't have a gun range in the city of Detroit either.
Where do you have your training? Where do you do your training?
Well, there's quite a few gun ranges that exist, you know, here in Metro Detroit, and they're just right outside of the border. They aren't too far away. You know, there's this one place, you know, Firearms Exchange, you know, that I go to, you know, quite a bit and use their range, man, and they're helpful staff. Guys are real cool and, you know, not overbearing, and, you know, they have a great, safe facility. So, you know, you find a spot that you like, man, and you operate there. But you know what? Going back before the break, we were talking about the story, right? And the story, you know, I got to reminiscing about it over the break, and I was just literally cracking myself up, man. It goes back to when a local media, you know, station outlet had contacted me. They wanted to do a story about guns and training, and we met up at a range, you know, outside Detroit, and we had some shots of me teaching, you know, another person, you know, how the training part would go, and then we were, I guess, wasting a lot of time. We weren't really good with our schedule, and we were running out of time, and the gun range operators were telling us, hey, you guys need to wrap this thing up. You guys need to shut down and leave. And so then I had to, you know, quickly, you know, get my gun together and then reload it and get ready to take this shot. And so I didn't really take a measured, you know, time shot. I was more or less shooting, you know, defensively, using defensive accuracy, and I might have missed the bullseye by like a half inch to the left, right? And so the studio, the local TV station, I was thinking they just wanted a picture of me shooting. Well, no, they went and they showed the target, right? And even though the target was self-defense distance, you know, about 15, 20 feet away, I might have missed the target to the left about a quarter to a half inch to the left. And I was ribbed, and my buddies, you know, they were like, ah, you missed the bullseye there, Rick. And, you know, that goes into, well, what type of shooting was I doing? You know, and that's a great segue into what we're talking about here. In terms of training, there's two types of shooting you should be doing. You know, the first type we're going to call defensive accuracy, and the second type of shooting when you train should be called marksmanship. So let me ask you, and I'm not trying to put you on the spot, but
sure,
there is a difference between marksmanship and defensive accuracy. Do you know what they are, sir?
Well, with marksmanship, and I don't worry about marksmanship when I'm training because all of mine is based upon defensive accuracy, which I'm trying to shoot at a steel plate that's a triangle.
Right.
And at the distance I'm shooting at, you know, it's not a very big triangle. So on the draw, and as I'm going forward, coming back, whatever it is, I'm shooting at that as fast as I can. And I miss it. I miss it sometimes. Most of the time I'm hitting it, ding, 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 ding. And
right.
Defensive accuracy for me is hitting that piece of metal. Not hitting it dead center, just hitting
right.
it. Because I'm trying to
right.
send a wall of lead that way.
Exactly. Exactly. And that is exactly the point that I drive home to people. Two types of shooting, right? The other type of shooting, we're talking about marksmanship. That's where you got your pretty silhouette up there
oh, yeah.
with the
yeah.
nice target. You might even have the ones with the concentric circles and obviously the smallest circle in the center. That's where you want to actually hit it, on the bullseye. And you're doing all the things right. You got a good grip, a perfect stance. You're moderating, you're modulating your breathing, you know, and you're lining up that perfect sight picture and you're hitting the bullseye. You know, that's not the type of shooting when you're shooting for defensive accuracy, as you explained before. So
right.
when I was doing that story with the TV, you know, show with the couple TV crew, I shot using, you know, defensive accuracy and missed the bullseye. And then, of course, you know, my friends on social media, they couldn't wait to howl and laugh at me. And I'm like, well, no. We were like, hey, let's get this shot done quick. Let's go ahead and make that shot. And I'm like, okay, I wasn't trying to hit the bullseye. I was just trying to get the shot using defensive accuracy. So, you know, I'm just now finally living that down. And now here I go and I bring it all up. Isn't that
you know,
funny?
That, we can talk about this in the next segment, but the idea, you want to make your mistakes when you're training.
Right.
The mere fact that you did that while you were training, if anybody was out there going, oh, Rick, look at that, oh, okay, well, you're sort of missing the whole point of training. You're training to make the mistakes so you can correct those mistakes. You're not training to be good. If you're already good, you probably shouldn't be training. But if you're just a normal human, you need to train. But we're talking.
You know,
this is. Hang on a minute. We're going into the break. Planet Rick. This is Planet Rick with Rick Ector. We'll be right back. This is Lock and Load.
Like a piece of Americana, this is Nighthawk Custom. Completing Browning's vision of the 1911, Nighthawk Custom is not a mass production facility. Each custom touch is machined to an exacting standard, with the heart and soul of each craftsman that takes it through the process. Traditional or tactical, Nighthawk Custom delivers a weapon you can trust with your life. Custom to your specification or ready to ship with the reserve line. For their complete selection, go to NighthawkCustom.com. Nighthawk Custom, one gun, one gunsmith. Every month we give away thousands of dollars in guns and gear at gunwinner.com. Catering to the shooter, hunter, prepper, or collector. All giveaways are free to enter courtesy of the contest sponsors. You can win guns from companies like Nighthawk Custom, Springfield, and many more. Every month, the giveaways, the contests, everything begins again, so go to gunwinner.com and enter to win. For all of your gun deals and giveaways, gunwinner.com.
Now you know. I will meet you there.
USA Radio News with Tim Berg.
Speaking outside the White House on Thursday, President Trump says the leaders of Baltimore have to be held accountable.
The people that have run Baltimore for so many years, they've run Baltimore into the ground. We've given billions and billions of dollars to Baltimore.
The president is in Cincinnati for one of his Make America Great Again rallies. Before heading out of town for their August recess, the Senate passes a budget deal.
The ayes are 67, the nays are 28, and the bill is passed.
23 Republicans voted no on the bill, expressing concern over soaring deficits and debt. The spending bill pushes the possibility of a big spending dispute past the 2020 elections, and it includes the suspension of the federal debt ceiling. Former FBI Director James Comey reportedly won't be charged over leaks of memos with possible classified information. Comey has admitted to leaking memos after he was fired by the president. This is USA Radio News.
Money, money, money. Money. You gotta have it. When you need it, what do? If you don't have a rich uncle, call LendingTree. With us, hundreds of banks compete for your business, so you'll get loans with competitive interest rates, and in some cases, with no closing costs. So here's the deal. If you need money, call us. Do you want to refinance your current loan? Are you 62 or older and interested in a reverse mortgage? Then call LendingTree now. 800-634-1315. 800-634-1315. We've closed over $250 billion in loans. We know what we're doing and can help you. Call right now for a free quote. 800-634-1315. 800-634-1315. 800-634-1315. That's 800-634-1315. NMLS number 1136.
If you feel you've been lied to, pressured, or misled into buying your timeshare, you have the right to cancel completely. This is Steve Sanchez, and I'd like to introduce you to Wesley Financial Group, the leading top-rated timeshare cancellation company in the country. That's right, no more excessive fees or lifetime commitments that make you feel like you're serving a prison sentence. Founded by CEO Chuck McDowell, a pioneer in the industry, who went into federal court and won against the largest timeshare resort company in the world just to help you get out of your timeshare. Too good to be true? No. Countless testimonials and the highest ratings from the Better Business Bureau make Wesley Financial Group the real deal, and their money-back guarantee they put in writing makes them the Steve Sanchez choice for successfully canceling your timeshare guaranteed. To get their free information kit, call 1-800-475-1919. That's 1-800-475-1919, or visit them at timesharecancellations.com. That's 1-800-475-1919.
From the AR-500 Armor Radio Studio, this is Lock and Load. This portion of the show is brought to you by Boyd's Gun Stocks.
Who needs a Boyd's Hardwood Gun Stock? Everyone. Crack stock? Back in action. Not the best fit? Now it's made for you. Tired look? Now the coolest gun in camp. Want tighter groups? Now you're more accurate than ever. A new Boyd's Hardwood Gun Stock will make your firearm fit, function, and look better than ever. Boyd's, rock your stock, rock your gun.
Indeed, check them out at boydsgunstocks.com. This is Planet Rick with Rick Ector. Had to interrupt you while you're getting ready to tell the story. Please tell the story.
Oh, man, I pretty much finished the story that we were talking about, man, but... Moving along, you know, one of the other things that is incumbent on us learning when we're doing our whole training regimen, of course, is this whole concept of drawing. I know earlier in the last segment, we made a difference between being in an urban shooting environment
right,
or being in somewhere more suburban or more out in the country. Well, here in the city, you know, particularly here in the Metro Detroit area, and I'm sure it probably exists to some extent elsewhere, they don't allow you to draw from a holster inside the gun range. And, like, there's a very good reason why they do that. You know, it's for the simple fact that, you know, there's no uniform way to ensure that everyone that produces a gun from a holster, wherever that holster is, whether it's outside the waistband or inside the waistband, that there's some uniform standard that people performing that operation, drawing their gun, are going to be safe and adhere to. So here in Metro Detroit, pretty much every gun range doesn't allow you to draw from the holster from a safety consideration. But see, here's the rub. If you're actually concealing your gun as you go about your day-to-day life and activities, and some threat to your safety manifests itself and you're legally justified in defending yourself, Well, guess what? You're going to need to draw your concealed gun. And it probably will not go as smoothly as you think it should if you don't practice. So obviously, you need to practice drawing your gun so that you can shoot it when you need to do so. And of course, if you're drawing, you're going to need to make sure you do so safely. Let me ask you, let me put you on the spot.
Sure.
How often do you actually draw your gun in a practice scenario? Do you practice drawing your gun?
Not often enough. Not often enough, without a doubt. Because the draw stroke, you know, like when I go to a class, correctly so, and you probably do it too. Every time I go to a class, wherever it is, they all presume that we don't know how to draw.
Mm-hmm.
So then we have to go through that refamiliarizing ourselves with it. Draw straight up at an angle, present, mm-hmm. right? Stepping right. off, trying to get off the X and everything, however they put it. And the other important thing about the draw stroke is how do you reholster the gun?
Exactly. And you know what?
Yes, sir.
No, and I'm just following along where I think you were headed.
Yeah.
You know, making sure that you properly reholster that gun and you don't do something, you know, unintentional or ill-advised where you might get a drawstring or something trapped into your actual gun where it actually gets caught in between, you know, your gun and your magazine as you're reholstering it. You know, if you do any search on the internet, you'll see where a lot of people have actually hurt themselves with negligent discharges where their gun, well, their magazine got trapped into a drawstring or that type of thing. So,
well, I mean, I've seen people shoot themselves drawing the gun. I've seen people shoot themselves putting the gun back in the holster. When the gun is out of the holster, the getting it out, and it's like an airplane. You know, the most dangerous time on the airplane is the takeoff and the landing.
Exactly.
So if the draw stroke is the takeoff, then the landing is going to be putting the gun back in the holster. And you got to do both of them just as precise as those pilots do, or else you're going to punch yourself in your own landing gear. So
exactly. So that just drives home the point that you need to practice drawing and reholstering your gun. And that's something that just can't be, you know, left to happenstance. You have to actually practice doing that and practice doing that safely. And I would suggest that you do it with an unloaded gun, you know, first and foremost, just perfecting that draw stroke and perfecting that there's no obstructions and that you're not having anything like drawstrings or anything else that can be trapped in there and lead to an unfortunate discharge.
Well, I mean, in Michigan now, you guys can have open carry, right? So you don't have to necessarily have a cover garment on your weapon if you don't want to, right?
No, I mean, you can legally open carry, you know, and I know we've talked about this on another show here in Michigan. You know, there's a lot of caveats that go along with open carry, and you'll probably need to have a concealed pistol license, you know, to cover you for the wide variety of applications of carrying a gun, but yeah, it's legal in general to open carry just as long as you're in compliance with all these laws we have, which is better if you have a concealed pistol license, even if you choose to open carry.
Right. But I mean, if you're going to practice, and like I do this. When I practice the draw, I pull my shirt back over it. I don't practice a draw with the shirt tucked in behind it. And so I have to have a cover shirt. So I don't ever tuck my shirt in. You know, you're never going to see me with a tucked in shirt. If you see me with a shirt untucked, I've got a gun on, because in South Carolina, we have no provision for open carry. We're all concealed. So,
that's a really interesting point because, you know, I see a lot of people here locally in Michigan that do that as well. And so the question I have for you is, for those of us who are more trained than the average beginner newbie, you know, does that become one of those poker tells, right? That one of those hints that someone's probably carrying a gun?
With an untucked shirt?
Right, the untucked shirt.
Well, definitely in the summertime, yeah. In the wintertime, too. I mean, especially in the wintertime, if they have on like two or three shirts and one shirt's untucked, I would think that's probably what it is. I'm always looking. I'm always looking for somebody. If somebody has a print on their shirt, I'm looking for that because a printed shirt hides a gun so much better. I'm always looking for, you know, most people are right-handed, so I'm always looking for a little bit more depth, you know, a little bit more something poking out of the shirt on his right hip than anywhere else. And that's if they're carrying outside the waistband. If they're carrying inside, it's a little harder. But I carry outside most of the time because I like to carry a big gun.
Well, yeah. You know, and here's the thing. I carry it. I think my gun's pretty big. It's a full size, you know.
Yeah, frame. You got the M&P, right? Yeah, so, I mean.
Yeah. So it's a full size
gun. It's a duty gun. That's a duty gun.
You know, those smaller guns, man, that whole trade-off between concealability and actual fit in my hand. It's, you know, I'd rather just have the full size gun. And, yeah, well, I do conceal it. But
we're coming up on the next break. I want to talk about that. I'd like to get your take on that because that is always a point of contention of mine when I'm talking about concealed carry because it seems like we're in the race to go to the smallest thing out there.
Uh-huh.
I mean, I've seen some guns that people carry as their carry gun that are smaller than my cigar lighter used to be when I smoked cigars. So if you would, Professor, if you would, just hang on right there. We're going to be right back. This is Planet Rick. With Rick Ector. He is the star of this urban armed self-defense instructor that he is. This is Lock and Load.
Most of you know that heart disease is the number one silent killer in the U.S. What if I told you for just $54.95 a month you could fight against heart disease naturally? At Heart and Body Extract, we've been helping thousands of people get back to a healthier heart. Don't just take my word for it. Check out all of the success stories at hvextract.com. Or to order, call 866-295-5305. That's 866-295-5305. hvextract.com. Don't risk it when you can take charge of it.
Tahibo Tea Club's original Pure Pau D'Arco Super Tea comes from the only tree in the world that fungus doesn't grow on. So it naturally has antifungal, antiviral, antibacterial, anti-infection, anti-inflammation, and anti-parasite properties. But maybe more importantly, Tahibo Tea Club's original Pure Pau D'Arco Super Tea builds corpuscles in the blood which carry oxygen to our organs and cells. Our organs and cells need oxygen to regenerate themselves. The immune system needs oxygen to develop, and cancer happens to die in oxygen. The tea is great for healthy people, and it can truly be miraculous for someone fighting a potentially life-threatening disease due to an infection, diabetes, or cancer. Tahibo Tea Club's original Pure Pau D'Arco Super Tea is only $34.95 plus shipping. Order now at shopsupertea.com or call 818-984-6100. That's shopsupertea.com or call 818-984-6100. Shopsupertea.com.
When it comes to retirement, employers and employees agree on some things but disagree on others. That's according to Diane Gallagher of American Century Investments.
In our latest survey, both groups say that debt is the biggest obstacle to saving. But while employers are most worried about market risk with investments, employees are more worried about longevity risk or running out of money. And employers think that more of their employees want to be left alone in saving than is actually true.
Learn more at AmericanCentury.com.
Would you like to get back that full head of hair from years past? Now, there is Reveal. Beverly Hills celebrity dermatologist Dr. Nathan Newman took nearly a decade to develop Reveal from natural botanicals to return to a full body head of hair. Reveal for men and women with a 30-day money-back guarantee at gcnlife.com or toll-free 844-443-6637. 844-443-6637. Reveal at gcnlife.com. Bags under the eyes, crow's feet, fine lines and wrinkles are things adults complain about as they age. Now, there's Instantly Ageless. It works in minutes and is great for men and women.
I've probably noticed in the past 5 years that my eyes have gained a lot of fine lines, wrinkles, my crow's feet have gotten deeper. Wow. I was hoping for 5 years, but that's like what my eyes looked like 10 years ago.
That is really cool.
Wrinkle gone?
It's easy. You just put it on your finger and go.
Now I wish I had more down here because I
can still see one wrinkle. It's bugging me.
I am a little bit emotional. Turning 40, I didn't think would be a big deal to me, but that looks like the me that I feel like inside instead of what I see when I look in the mirror.
Try Instantly Ageless today at GCNLife.com. That's GCNLife.com. 30-day money-back guarantee and preferred price discount at GCNLife.com. That's GCNLife.com.
Complement your health with hemp-derived cannabinoid oil. We've always believed that the closer to Earth, the better it is for our bodies. Our hemp-derived cannabinoid oil is phytocannabinoid-rich, full-spectrum, and organically grown. Finally, hemp made easy, clean, and effective. GCNHemp.com or call 877-878-4203. That's right, we cut through the red tape. It's now available at GCNHemp.com or call 877-878-4203.
Live from the AR 500 Armor Radio Studio, this is Lock and Load. This portion of the show is brought to you by Boyd's Gunstocks.
Who needs a Boyd's hardwood gun stock? Everyone. Crack stock? Back in action. Not the best fit? Now it's made for you. Tired look? Now the coolest gun in camp. Want tighter groups? Now you're more accurate than ever. A new Boyd's hardwood gun stock will make your firearm fit, function, and look better than ever. Boyd's, rock your stock, rock your gun.
Indeed, check them out at boydsgunstocks.com. Talking with, this is Planet Rick with Rick Ector.
Hey, armed. Man, I am back.
Say again. I'm sorry. Yeah.
No, we're gonna work this timing thing out, man. It, you know what? It's coming along great.
I think so.
The chemistry is getting even better, and I'm learning how you do things and set things up, man. I'm telling you, I'm getting so much out of this. I hope that your listeners are getting info out of us working together as I'm getting the craft of doing a show. I feel like I'm getting better by leaps and bounds every time I come on.
Well, I would agree with you on that one. It really is a sense of timing and everything. So, but that's cool. But now I want to go into something that I'm always wanting to know about. I always want to ask an instructor about. With this, in this race, to get to the smallest gun known to man, because apparently people want to be completely they don't want to feel like they're carrying a gun. They don't want to be discomforted. I'm of the opinion that if it's not a gun that I can practice with and shoot 1,000 times in an afternoon, I don't need to be carrying it because I'm not training with it. What are your thoughts on that?
You know, I carry a full-size gun, and I feel for me personally, it works best for me. But obviously, I can't superimpose my thoughts on everyone else because everyone else has considerations that they want to keep in mind. But there are some trade-offs that go along with this whole how big of a gun should I carry thing, right? You're talking about capacity. Obviously, the smaller the gun you're going to have, the smaller capacity you're going to have. So you got one of those teeny tiny micro guns, and let's just say you have 3, 5, 7 rounds. I mean, and it's true enough, the stats bear it out. You probably won't need 16 rounds, but hey, man, you never know what could happen. You know, because marksmanship is going to suffer if you're in a high-stress situation. Other considerations is concealability. Yeah. Do you want to carry a gun and have that big, giant bulge and have people, you know, just assume that it's a gun when it could be one of those big, giant cell phones that people carry today? Also, size affects recoil, right? Those smaller micro guns, and if you have a decent caliber on that gun, it's going to move more and be more difficult to control. And of course, that's going to affect your accuracy. And of course, the other thing I hear a lot from people is weight.
some people really feel that they're being weighed down by that gun, carrying it all day, every day. But I'll tell you, for me personally, I actually feel weird when I don't feel that weight. And in terms of concealability, you know, I'm not trying to say I'm, you know, Adonis, you know, that I'm a physical specimen that needs to be, you know, behold when you see me. But you know what? I have lost enough weight off my stomach and gut area where I can hide it pretty good. And
right.
No one will ever see it.
Gut area. You don't have a gut area.
You know, people get so self-conscious about bulges and you know, and their body shape and how they look, you know, when they walk out the door. You know, this whole, do I tuck my shirt in or just leave, you know, the ends, the tails just hanging outside, you know, just flopping in the wind, you know. Does it become a style vanity issue? You know, ultimately, at the end of the day, it's all personal preference. And you know what? There's people that believe concealed means concealed, and they don't want to give away any hints that they might be carrying. But you know what? When you do this thing, as long as we have, I can spot up or size up a person and be like, yeah, just based on how they're wearing their clothes, you know, especially the tails, you know, outside of the pants just flopping in the air. Yeah, I'm like, okay, now I'm secretly, you know, sizing them up for bulges. And whether he's favoring a certain side or, you
right.
know, the beginners, they always got to keep tapping and touching it every so often, you know, make sure it hasn't disappeared. You know, all those tails that somebody's carrying.
Well, I like one thing I do, like when I'm standing around, I'll put my hands on my hips and one hand is just around the top of the gun coming out of the holster. And I do that just so I can stand the way I want to stand. And, you know, I don't make any, I'm not, you know, I'm not outlining the gun on the shirt or anything.
Uh-huh.
But the smallest gun I will carry has already been modified to such a degree that it's no longer what it was supposed to be because of the capacity issue.
Right.
Because I have a Glock 43 that I've carried a few times. And I talked to the guy at Hive, and I told him one of my problems was capacity. And now it has a 9-round capacity, but, you know, now it's losing some of its concealability.
Right.
And then,
you know, and that's the thing, man. You know, when you get into carrying this gun, I think many people, in my opinion, you know, they get overly concerned as to whether it can be, you know, identified that you're carrying a gun. I think your behaviors and certain actions physically that you do give you away more so than an actual bunch.
Yeah. Yeah. I try to, you know.
So, you know, and it's a mental thing, really. You know, I think that once you pass the visual test, and you actually are modeling in your full-length mirror like a lot of gun people do before they walk out the door.
Right.
You know, you just have to just trust that when you leave that mirror that you made a good decision as to how concealed your gun is, and trust that it's concealed.
Well, you know, that is one thing, right? All of the new people out there that are listening just got their permit. When you do conceal it, it is concealed. Don't worry about it. Nobody's going to see it. Nobody's going to notice it. Nobody's going to know psychic. As a matter of fact, it's sort of amazing how many people don't observe other people, isn't it?
Man, let me tell you, I observe everyone. And, you know, it's like a habit that I'd had to develop at first when I first started caring. But after a while, you do something so long for so long, it's just instinctive. And, you know,
right.
when I look at people, I'm scanning and looking. I'm like, okay, where's the gun? Can I see the gun? You know, I'll do it all the time. And
yeah, but I'm talking about the non-carriers. The non-carriers don't look.
Well, you know, because they assume that since they don't carry, no one else is carrying.
That's right.
And see, since we
right.
carry, you know, we assume just about everyone else is carrying. And, you know, how nosy we are and inquisitive we are, we're actually looking for.
I think we probably give ourselves away with those polite, you know, being polite and having good manners. Because we treat everybody else like they're armed, you know, so.
Right. you know, we're carrying guns and, you know, we know that there's other guns out there. And so we engage in, like our friend, you know, the polite society, you know, we're engaging in this polite society, and you give yourself away by being so doggone polite and nice to people when everyone else is just rude.
Right. We are about to run out of time. We got about a minute left. So real quick, tell everybody how they can find Rick Ector.
Man, you can find me all over the place. The best way is to just search for my name, R-I-C-K, Rick Ector, E-C-T-O-R. I am just about everywhere in social media. I have an account at Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube. I'm all over the place. Literally, you can't find me. If you can't find me, you weren't doing a decent job of looking, and eventually I'm going to get to a point where you can search Planet Rick and find me. But I have to keep coming back and being on this show, educating and sharing with your audience that I have so much fun doing every week here, Thursday evening, 7 p.m. Eastern.
Very good, sir. Thank you for joining us this evening.
Hey, man, thank you for having me. It's always a pleasure, and I look forward to next week.
Yes, sir. Coming up next, hour number three is inbound. This is Lock and Load. What's in a name? If that name is Ace Firearms, you've just entered a very expensive business. First, a fully appointed gun shop with all the guns, ammo, and accessories you could possibly imagine. But then you enter the manufacturing facility that is home to Red Alligator Concealment, Militia Arms Customs, and so much more. Ace Firearms is beyond a simple gun shop. This is a totally peerless operation. To find out more, go to acefirearms.com. Ace Firearms. This is only the beginning.
Who needs a Boyd's hardwood gun stock? Everyone. Crack stock? Back in action. Not the best fit? Now it's made for you. Tired look? Now the coolest gun in camp. Want tighter groups? Now you're more accurate than ever. A new Boyd's hardwood gun stock will make your firearm fit, function, and look better than ever. Boyd's. Rock your stock. Rock your gun.
Jake was in big trouble with the IRS. He owed how much?
$92,000.
Ouch. The IRS left no room for Jake to breathe.
They put a lien on my house, took all the money out of my bank account, took money out of my paychecks. So it was a nightmare.
He needed help fast.
I figured that all these companies were the same until I called Federal Tax Management. You could just tell they knew what they were talking about. Right then and there, I felt like I had some hope.
Stop the liens, levies, and garnishments fast and qualify for one of several special IRS programs that could reduce or even eliminate your tax debt. So, how'd it go for Jake?
They did what they said they would do. They came through for me. I ended up saving an unbelievable amount. I was so jazzed. I was extremely happy.
If you owe more than $10,000 in back taxes, take Jake's advice.
Give Federal Tax Management a phone call. If they help me, they can help anybody.
Call the Federal Tax Management Hotline now. 800-503-8625. 800-503-8625. 800-503-8625.